Coach, thank you for joining us here as we get ready for the championship game, and congratulations on Coach of the Year this year.
Hey, thank you. I appreciate it.
Now, with an addition to Coach of the Year, 20-win season, number one seed, a very special group. What has made this season so special?
You know what? I think we just got a connected group, a bunch of guys that have bought into each other, bought into who we are as a brand, our Wagner basketball brand. And for that, it's just been, it's been not easy, but it's been fun to coach and be a part of.
And you're coming off the semifinal win against LIU. The semifinals has kind of been the Achilles heel for Wagner over the last few years. You're down at halftime, foul trouble early in the second half. What sparked your team to finally get over that hump in tournament? What made this time different?
You know what, the only thing I said at halftime, I didn't think it was X and O's that were that was bothering us. I thought we played a little timid. I thought they played a little bit harder than us. I just told our guys, this is it. You got 20 minutes of basketball left. And, you know, there's no practice tomorrow. There's no meetings. There's nothing like that. So if you're going to lose the game playing hard. I don't care about fouls. I don't care about, you know, situations in the game. I just want us to be the hardest playing team on the court. And I think we did that, and the result was a win.
Now, when a lot of people interview you or ask you questions or talk about you, a lot of times age comes up in the conversation. But, you know, you're only 1 year older than me, so I appreciate what you're doing for all us 30-year-old people out there, showing that we, you know, young people know what they're doing. But if you could go back in time and talk to yourself at 28, just taking over this program, is there anything you know now that you wish you could have told yourself back then?
You know what? It's never as good as it seems. It's never as bad as it seems. You know, as a young 28-year-old taking over a program that had just won the most games in school history at 25, I felt like I was under a microscope. And really, the microscope was my own two eyes and in my head, trying to live up to that. So even going into the championship game tomorrow, it's never too high, never too low. Got 40 minutes to play basketball, and the results are going to be what they're going to be.
You played under and coached with Coach Hurley and before taking over this job from him. What was the most important thing that he taught you?
You know what? Preparation. Be who you are as a coach every day. Drive your guys really hard. Make sure you're prepared so that the kids are prepared. And again, the games are going to be what they're going to be.
And the Wagner Seahawks are the number one scoring defense in the NEC. I know defense is right up your alley. Yeah. What makes this Wagner defense so good, so efficient, so effective?
You know what I think, and I say this to my guys all the time, the other team, they pick on the worst defender from the opposing team. So if you don't want to be that guy, then don't be a weak defender. And I think, a lot of the times we have five guys on the court that care about defense, which, make it hard to score on us.
Now, you look at the challenges that FDU possesses. They're the number one scoring offense, 77 points per game. So what are some of the challenges in terms of slowing them down and containing them?
We got five guys on the court that like to play defense. They got five guys on the court that could really score the ball offensively. So you just got to you got to break them down in small little parts. The first thing is not give them any easy baskets in transition. And sprint back and make them play half-court offense. And then once they're in the half-court, it comes down to individual defense with these guys. They don't run very many sets offensively. So it'll come down to you versus your guy. Can you guard them? Can you stay in front of them within our team principles?
What do you anticipate the environment being like? Game time approaching, place is packed. This is a loud gym. It gets loud real quick. What do you anticipate the environment being like for this championship game?
You know what? I think it'll be fun. I think it'll be great for our guys, both teams, a fun atmosphere to play in. But that's one of the least things of my concern. I just want my guys focused on playing basketball. The circus that's going on around us that's what it is. It's just around us. It has nothing to do with what we're trying to do.
What would it mean to this community, this school, who only once has gone to the NCAA tournament, to have the opportunity to go back?
I think it'll be a great thing. This is something, this is why you get into coaching, this is why you play the game, to have a chance to play an NCAA tournament. I know everybody's excited about it. My players are, I am, and, again, we got 40 minutes to live out our dreams.
Now, I read an article that when you first took over the program, you said that when you got the word that you were hired, you let out a shout in your apartment and you're beating your chest. So if that was the reaction for getting the job, how will you react at the end of the game if your team's cutting down the nets?
You know what, I don't know, but it'll be an out-of-body experience, so I'm sure whatever the reaction will be, it'll be something like beating my chest and jumping on the scores table screaming.
Because, I mean, you've done a lot of things, you certainly accomplished a lot, but NCAA tournament's the one thing missing, so yeah. I'm sure that would mean a lot to you just to get there.
It's the reason why I'm coaching. to be a part of that tournament.
Well, Coach, best of luck to you, and we look forward to the championship game.
Thanks, I appreciate it.